Welcome back to Proactive. I'm joined on the line now by Jasmine Skee, the CEO of GILD Esports. Jasmine, it's great to have you on the line now. And some big news out just this morning. You've launched something called GILD Studios. Perhaps you'd like to tell us a bit about it.
Yeah, absolutely. Thanks for having me again, Tom. I'm delighted to announce the launch of GILD Studios. GILD Studios allows us to connect with brands on a campaign basis. So we know that brands really want to be talking to Gen Z, Gen Alpha, and also being in the space of esports and gaming, because that really is what they love and that's what they want to connect with. So we see this as being a new revenue opportunity because we have the skill set internally at GILD. So we're looking to monetize that by using that skill set and creating bespoke solutions for brands around creative, production, social media, experiential, and also talent. So since we soft launched in January, we're already at revenue figures in the six figures, which is really great. And we're really looking forward to doing this work with brands and helping them connect and being the expertise that brands do want when it comes to esports and gaming.
Well, one of those brands that you've already been working with there, Jasmine, is Samsung Mobile. So what have you done for them?
Yeah, we're really excited to work with Samsung Mobile. They launched their Samsung Galaxy S23 in February and approached us for how we could help amplify the gaming capabilities of that handset. So on the 16th and 17th of February, we went down to Westfield White City where they had a store set up and we did a talent activation with them. This is obviously being driven by GILD Studios. Then what we did last week was we did a thing called Roll Up to Esports and Gaming, where people could come down and learn a lot more. But with what we did was center the capabilities of that handset around that activation. So people really started to understand what that handset could do when it came to gaming. So really excited to be working with Samsung Mobile in this way. It just shows that, you know, brands do want to work at a campaign level. And it's slightly different to how we work with the other Samsung divisions. So Samsung are sponsors when it comes to display and TV, and they're fantastic sponsors in that space. But what we're really excited about is working with Samsung Mobile on a project basis and what could come out of the back of this work that we are doing with them.
Great stuff, Jasmine. And you've also recently announced a new CFO as well. What can you tell us about her?
Yeah, very excited to have another woman at GILD on our C-suite. Claire has some phenomenal experience that she's going to bring to GILD, especially around finance and executive management. I think we're really lucky to have her. She's joined us from Audible, which is a company owned by Amazon. It's audio publishing. And when she was there, she did a lot of work around, you know, efficiencies around spend, as well as also marketing and promotional activity and really looking at strategic investments when it comes to finance. So all that experience is just perfect for what we need at GILD. She was also at a product that I absolutely love and got to work with at day one, which is Shazam. Like, I really love what Shazam did. And she worked with them when it came to fundraising and supporting the executive management in that space. And they went through three rounds of fundraising and raised $90 million. So I'm super happy that Claire is joining us. I think we're very lucky to have her. And she'll also be coming on as our company secretary.
And she's not actually the only new face, is she? You've got somebody else starting at the beginning of March.
Yeah, we have actually a couple of new hires that we announced, the first one being Matthew Charles. So Charlie has been in with GILD consulting in our esports and teams department. We call him Charlie. He's been a massive asset, and I think we're so lucky to now have him come on as our director of operations. Charlie has 17 years experience working in high growth sport technology companies, and I think that is just perfect for where we are as GILD, and really excited to have him on board. He does have C-suite experience, and I think he will be a great asset to us as a leader. The other announcement was Alan Vaughan, who is our senior communications manager. And Alan has joined us from FIFA, where he worked on the Qatar World Cup, so a massive project with phenomenal experience out there. And he also delivered the European Club Association Women's Strategy for football, which is the first of its kind. And this really aligns with us because we are so committed to women in gaming. So having Alan come in with that experience is just super for us, and we really can't wait to have him on board. This also supports the three announcements I made in January, where we've seen, you know, those three really get their feet under the table and do great things. But we had Nick Westwood come in as our SVP of Creative and Strategy. We had Luke Jones join us from Red Bull Gaming, so bringing some awesome experience as our Director of Esports and Gaming. And we've had Georgia Morrison come in as our Head of HQ and Events and really supporting us on how we monetize the SkyGuild Gaming Center. So I just think we've brought in some real talent into Guild and really looking forward to what comes next.
Understood, Jasmine. And just one final question from me. How does Guild Studios fit into the wider Guild Esports strategy? And what do you think we can expect from it in the future?
We're always looking at new revenue streams at Guild and how we can diversify that. And we're always looking at how we can drive value for our shareholders. You know, and when we announced our results at the end of January, we talked a lot about our audience growth. And that audience growth was really focusing on growing with Gen Z and Gen Alpha. We're working with Little Dots on that to really focus on vertical video and platforms such as TikTok and Snapchat. So as we grow that audience out, one thing that is really important to understand is Gen Alpha, 94% of them say that they are gaming enthusiasts. Now, they're not interested in gaming, they're enthusiasts. So if you take that being our key audience and the key audience for esports and gaming, we really believe Guild Studios, and I think working with Samsung is a good example of that, is we will grow, we will start supporting brands, helping them connect with those two audiences, and helping them connect with this passion point that is esports and gaming, and being the people that come in and really guide these brands and make sure that they're activating their brand and media campaigns in a way that really demonstrates that they understand this space and this passion point. So I'm really excited to continue to drive revenue for Guild through Guild Studios and also shareholder value.
Understood. Well, it sounds like you've got plenty on your plate, Jasmine, so we'll let you get back to it. But have a great week, and thanks for joining us today on Proactive.
No problem. Thanks, Tom. It's great to see you again.